This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Cardiff I, K-R-D-F, Welsh, Cardiff Info, Cardiff, Cardiff, is the capital and largest city in Wales and the 10th largest city in the United Kingdom. The city is the country's chief commercial centre, the base for most national cultural and sporting institutions, the Welsh national media, and the seat of the National Assembly for Wales. The Unitary Authority area's mid-2011 population was estimated to be 346,100, while the population of the larger urban zone was estimated at 861,400 in 2009. The Cardiff metropolitan area makes up over a third of the total population of Wales, with a mid-2011 population estimate of about 1,100,000 people. Cardiff is a significant tourist centre and the most popular visitor destination in Wales, with 183.1980s, Cardiff has seen significant development. A new waterfront area at Cardiff Bay contains the Senedd Building, home to the Welsh Assembly and the Wales Millennium Centre Arts Complex. Current developments include the continuation of the redevelopment of the Cardiff Bay and city centre areas, with projects such as the Cardiff International Sports Village, a BBC drama village, and a new business district in the city centre. Sporting venues in the city include the Millennium Stadium, the national stadium for the Wales National Rugby Union team, SWALEC Stadium, the home of Glamorgan County Cricket Club, Cardiff City Stadium, the home of Cardiff City Football Team, Cardiff International Sports Stadium, the home of Cardiff Amateur Athletic Club, and Cardiff Arms Park, the home of Cardiff Blues and Cardiff RFC Rugby Union teams. The city was awarded the title of European City of Sport twice, due to its role in hosting major international sporting events, first in 2009 and again in 2014. The Millennium Stadium hosted 11 football matches as part of the 2012 Summer Olympics, including the game's opening event and the men's bronze medal match. Contents 1. Etymology 2. History 21. Origins 22. Norman occupation to the Middle Ages 23. County town of Glamorganshire 24. Building of the docks 25. City and capital city status 3. Government 31. Local government 4. Geography 41. Cityscape 42. Climate 43. Temperature 44. Sunshine hours 45. Rainfall 5. Demography 51. Language 511. Language schools 52. Religion 53. Health 6. Economy 61. Shopping 7. Transport 71. Rail 72. Air 73. Road and bus 74. Cycle 75. Water 8. Telecommunications 9. Education 10. Landmarks and attractions 11. Culture and recreation 111. Music and performing arts 112. Visual arts 113. Recreation 12. Media 13. Sport 14. Notable people 15. International relations 16. See also 17. References 18. External links. Etymology: the front wall of Cardiff Castle, showing part of the original Roman fort from which the city probably derived its name. Cardiff. The Welsh name of the city derives from the earlier Welsh form Cerdyff. The change from DYF to DYDD shows the colloquial alteration of Welsh F and DD, and was perhaps also driven by folk etymology. DYDD is Welsh for day, whereas DYF has no obvious meaning. This sound change had probably first occurred in the Middle Ages. Both forms were current in the Tudor period. Cerdyff has its origins in post-Roman Brythonic words meaning the fort of the Taf. The fort probably refers to that established by the Romans. Caer is Welsh for fort, and Dyf is in effect a form of Taf, Taf, the river which flows by Cardiff Castle, with the T showing consonant mutation to D and the vowel showing affection as a result of a lost genitive case ending the anglicized form. Cardiff is derived from Cerdyff, with the Welsh F borrowed as FF, F, as also happens in Taf from Welsh Taf and Landaf from Welsh Landoff. As English does not have the vowel, the final vowel has been borrowed as. The antiquarian William Camden 1551-1623 suggested that the name Cardiff may derive from Caer Didi, the fort of Didius, a name supposedly given in honour of Aulus Didius Gallus, governor of a nearby province at the time when the Roman fort was established. Although some sources repeat this theory, it has been rejected on linguistic grounds by modern scholars such as Professor Gwyneth Pierce. History. Main articles: History of Cardiff and Timeline of Cardiff. History. Origins. Tribes of Wales at the time of the Roman invasion. The modern English-Welsh border is also shown. Archaeological evidence from sites in and around Cardiff. The St. Lythan's burial chamber, near Wenvo, about 4 miles 64. Enclosure sites have been identified within Cardiff's present-day county boundaries, including Carrow Hillfort, an enclosed area of 51 hectares 51,000. Departure from Britain and the Norman conquest. The settlement probably shrank in size and may even have been abandoned in the absence of Roman rule. Wales was divided into small kingdoms. Early on, Murug ap Tudrig emerged as the local king in Glywysing, which later became Glamorgan. The area passed through his family until the advent of the Normans in the 11th century. Norman occupation to the Middle Ages. View of Cardiff Castle in 1081. William I, King of England, began work on the castle keep within the walls of the old Roman fort. Cardiff Castle has been at the heart of the city ever since. The castle was substantially altered and extended during the Victorian period by John Crichton Stuart, 3rd Marquess of Bute, and the architect William Burgess. Original Roman work can, however, still be distinguished in the wall facings. A town grew up in the shadow of the castle, made up primarily of settlers from England. Cardiff had a population of between 1,500 and 2,000 in the Middle Ages, a relatively normal size for a Welsh town in this period. It was the centre of the Norman Marcher Lordship of Glamorgan, and by the end of the 13th century, Cardiff was the only town in Wales with a population exceeding 2,000, although it remained relatively small compared with most notable towns in the Kingdom of England, and continued to be very much contained by its walls, which has begun as a wooden palisade in the early 12th century. It was nonetheless of sufficient size and importance to be awarded a series of charters, notably in 1331 by William La Zouche, Lord of Glamorgan through marriage with the de Clare family, Edward III in 1359, then Henry IV in 1400, and later Henry VI in no small part due to the historic Anglicization of the town. In 1404, Owain Glyndwr burned Cardiff and took possession of the castle, as many buildings in the town were made of timber, and tightly packed together within the town walls. Much of Cardiff was destroyed. Ironically, given the treatment of Cardiff by Glyndwr, a statue of him was erected in Cardiff Town Hall in the early 20th century, reflecting the complex and often conflicting cultural identity Cardiff has as the capital of Wales. However, the town was soon rebuilt on the same street plan and began to flourish once again, in addition to serving an important political role in the governance of the fertile South Glamorgan coastal plain. Cardiff was a busy port in the Middle Ages due to its location on the Bristol trading routes, and was declared a staple port in 1327. This furthermore led to the town gaining a reputation for piracy, which by the early modern period led to much dispute between the burgesses of Cardiff and the surrounding county families. County town of Glamorganshire. John Speed's map of Cardiff from 1610. Cardiff Old Town Hall, 1860 and 1536. The Act of Union between England and Wales led to the creation of the Shire of Glamorgan, and Cardiff was made the county town. It also became part of Cabourg Hundred. Citation needed. Around this same time, the Herbert family became the most powerful family in the area. In 1538, Henry VIII closed the Dominican and Franciscan friaries in Cardiff, the remains of which were used as building materials. A writer around this period described Cardiff: the River Taff runs under the walls of his honour's castle, and from the north part of the town to the south part, where there is a fair quay and a safe harbour for shipping. Cardiff had become a free borough in 1542, and further royal charters were granted to the town by Elizabeth I in 1600 and James I in 1608. In 1573, it was made a head port for collection of customs duties. Pembrokeshire historian George Owen described Cardiff in 1602 as the fairest town in Wales, yet not the wealthiest, and the town gained a second royal charter in 1608. A disastrous flood of the Bristol Channel on 30 January 1607, now believed to be a tsunami, led to a change in the course of the River Taff and the ruining of St. Mary's Parish Church, which was replaced by its chapel of ease, St. John the Baptist. During the Second English Civil War, St. Fagans, just to the west of the town, played host to the Battle of St. Fagans. The battle, between a royalist rebellion and a new model army detachment, was a decisive victory for the parliamentarians and allowed Oliver Cromwell to conquer Wales. It is the last major battle to occur in Wales, with about 200 mostly royalist soldiers killed in the ensuing century. Cardiff was at peace in 1766. John Stuart, 1st Marquess of Bute, married into the Herbert family and was later created Baron Cardiff, and in 1778 he began renovations on Cardiff Castle. In the 1790s, a racecourse, printing press, bank and coffee house all opened, and Cardiff gained a stagecoach service to London. Despite these improvements, Cardiff's position in the Welsh urban hierarchy had declined over the 18th century. Iolo Morgan W.G. called it an obscure obscure and inconsiderable place, and the 1801 census found the population to be only 1,870, making Cardiff only the 25th largest town in Wales, well behind Merthyr and Swansea. Building of the docks. Main article, Cardiff Docks. Cardiff Docks, from where coal was shipped throughout the world. A view of the Jubilee Dock, Cardiff, from the eastern side, 1849. In 1793, John Crichton Stewart, 2nd Marquess of Bute, was born. He would spend his life building the Cardiff Docks and would later be called the creator of modern Cardiff. A twice-weekly boat service between Cardiff and Bristol was established in 1815, and in 1821, the Cardiff Gas Works was established. After the Napoleonic Wars, Cardiff entered a period of social and industrial unrest, starting with the trial and hanging of Dick Penderin in 1831. The town grew rapidly from the 1830s onwards, when the Marquess of Bute built a dock, which eventually linked to the Taff Vale Railway. Cardiff became the main port for exports of coal from the Cunnan, Rhondda, and Rhymney valleys, and grew at a rate of nearly 80% per decade between 1840 and 1870. Much of the growth was due to migration from within and outside Wales. In 1841, a quarter of Cardiff's population were English-born, and more than 10% had been born in Ireland by the 1881 census. Cardiff had overtaken both Merthyr and Swansea to become the largest town in Wales. Cardiff's new status as the premier town in South Wales was confirmed when it was chosen as the site of the University College South Wales and Monmouthshire in 1893. A permanent military presence was established in the town with the completion of Maindy Barracks in 1877. Cardiff faced a challenge in the 1880s when David Davies of Landingham and the Bury Railway Company promoted the development of rival docks at Bury. Bury Docks had the advantage of being accessible in all tides, and David Davies claimed that his venture would cause grass to grow in the streets of Cardiff. From 1901, coal exports from Bury surpassed those from Cardiff, but the administration of the coal trade remained centered on Cardiff, in particular its coal exchange, where the price of coal on the British market was determined and the first £1 million deal was struck in 1907. The city also strengthened its industrial base with the decision of the owners of the Dolace Ironworks in Merthyr, who would later form part of Guest, Keene and Nettlefolds, to build a new steelworks close to the docks at East Moors, which Lord Bute opened on 4 February 1891. City and capital city status. Welsh National War Memorial. King Edward VII granted Cardiff city status on 28 October 1905, and the city acquired a Roman Catholic cathedral in 1916. In subsequent years, an increasing number of national institutions were located in the city, including the National Museum of Wales, Welsh National War Memorial, and the University of Wales Registry Building. However, it was denied the National Library of Wales, partly because the library's founder, Sir John Williams, considered Cardiff to have a non-Welsh population. After a brief post-war boom, Cardiff Docks entered a prolonged decline in the interwar period. By 1936, their trade was less than half its value in 1913, reflecting the slump in demand for Welsh coal. Bomb damage during the Cardiff Blitz in World War II included the devastation of Llandaff Cathedral, and in the immediate post-war years the city's link with the Bute family came to an end. National Museum of Wales, Cardiff. The city was proclaimed Capital City of Wales on 20 December 1955, by a written reply by the Home Secretary. Gwilym Lloyd George Caernarvon had also vied for this title. Cardiff therefore celebrated two important anniversaries in 2005. The Encyclopedia of Wales notes that the decision to recognise the city as the capital of Wales had more to do with the fact that it contained marginal Conservative constituencies than any reasoned view of what functions a Welsh capital should have. Although the city hosted the Commonwealth Games in 1958, Cardiff only became a centre of national administration with the establishment of the Welsh Office in 1964, which later prompted the creation of various other public bodies such as the Arts Council of Wales and the Welsh Development Agency, most of which were based in Cardiff. Redevelopment in the city's historic Cardiff Bay area. The East Moors Steelworks closed in 1978 and Cardiff lost population during the 1980s, consistent with a wider pattern of counter-urbanisation in Britain. However, it recovered and was one of the few cities outside London where population grew during the 1990s. During this period, the Cardiff Bay Development Corporation was promoting the redevelopment of South Cardiff. An evaluation of the regeneration of Cardiff Bay published in 2004 concluded that the project had reinforced the competitive position of Cardiff and contributed to a massive improvement in the quality of the built environment, although it had failed to attract the major inward investors originally anticipated. In the Welsh devolution referendum, 1997, Cardiff voters rejected the establishment of the National Assembly for Wales by 554% to 442% on a 47% turnout, which Dennis Balsam partly ascribed to a general preference in Cardiff and some other parts of Wales for a British rather than exclusively Welsh identity. The relative lack of support for the Assembly locally, and difficulties between the Welsh office and Cardiff Council in acquiring the original preferred venue, Cardiff City Hall, encouraged other local authorities to bid to house the Assembly. However, the Assembly eventually located at Tai Hwell in Cardiff Bay in 1999. In 2005, a new debating chamber on an adjacent site, designed by Richard Rogers, was opened. The city was county town of Glamorgan until the council reorganisation in 1974 paired Cardiff and the now Vale of Glamorgan together as the new county of South Glamorgan. Further local government restructuring in 1996 resulted in Cardiff City's district council becoming a unitary authority, the City and County of Cardiff, with the addition of Crieshiau and Pentyrch government. Cardiff City Hall in Cathays Park. Main article, Politics in Cardiff. See also, Cardiff Council and National Assembly for Wales. Since local government reorganisation in 1996, Cardiff has been governed by the City and County Council of Cardiff, which is based at County Hall in Atlantic Wharf. Cardiff Bay voters elect 75 councillors every 4 years between the 2004 and 2012 local elections. No individual political party held a majority on Cardiff County Council. The Liberal Democrats held the largest number of seats, and CLLR Rodney Berman was leader of the council. The Liberal Democrats and Plaid Cymru formed a partnership administration in the 2012 elections. The Labour Party achieved an outright majority, after gaining an additional 33 seats across the city. The Senedd, seat of the Welsh Assembly, is located in Cardiff Bay. The National Assembly for Wales has been based in Cardiff Bay since its formation in 1999. The building, known as the Senedd, which translates into English as Legislature, Parliament or Senate, was opened on 1 March 2006, by the Queen. The Assembly members AMS, the Assembly Commission and Ministerial Support Staff are based in Cardiff Bay. Cardiff elects 4 constituency assembly members AMS to the Assembly, with the individual constituencies for the Assembly being the same as for the UK Parliament. All of the city's residents have an extra vote for the South Wales Central Region, which increases proportionality to the Assembly. The most recent Welsh Assembly general election were held on 5 May 2016. Crown buildings are the Welsh Government's main offices in Cardiff. In the Assembly, Cardiff is represented by Jenny Rathbone Labour in Cardiff Central, Julie Morgan Labour in Cardiff North, Vaughan Gething Labour in Cardiff South and Penarth, and Mark Drakiford Labour in Cardiff West in Westminster. Cardiff is represented by Joe Stevens Labour in Cardiff Central, Craig Williams Conservative in Cardiff North, Stephen Doughty Labour in Cardiff South and Penarth, and Kevin Brennan Labour in Cardiff West. The Welsh Government has its headquarters in Cardiff's Cathays Park, where most of its civil servants are based, with smaller numbers in other locations in the city centre, Cathays, Canton, and Cardiff Bay. There are other Welsh Government offices in other parts of Wales, such as Llandudno and Aberystwyth, and international offices throughout the world. Local government communities of Cardiff that have their own community council for local government purposes. Cardiff is divided into communities. Several of these have their own community council, while the rest are governed solely by Cardiff City Council. They are Lisvain Old Street, Mellons Pentyrch, Radier and Morganstown Street, Fagans Tongwynlay. Geography. Looking south towards Cardiff city centre. Main article, Geography of Cardiff. The centre of Cardiff is relatively flat and is bounded by hills on the outskirts to the east, north and west. Its geographic features were influential in its development as the world's largest coal port, most notably its proximity and easy access to the coal fields of the South Wales Valleys. The highest point in the authority is Garth Hill, 307 metres 1,007 feet above sea level. Cardiff is built on reclaimed marshland on a bed of Triassic stones. This reclaimed marshland stretches from Chepstow to the Ely estuary, which is the natural boundary of Cardiff and the Vale of Glamorgan. Triassic landscapes of this part of the world are usually shallow and low-lying, which accounts and explains the flatness of the centre of Cardiff. The classic Triassic marl, sand and conglomerate rocks are used predominantly throughout Cardiff as building materials. Many of these Triassic rocks have a purple complexion, especially the coastal marl found near Penarth. One of the Triassic rocks used in Cardiff is Radier Stone, a Freestone, which as its name suggests is quarried in the Radyr district. Cardiff has also imported some materials for buildings. Devonian sandstones. The old red sandstone from the Brecon Beacons has been used most famously. The buildings of Cathays Park, the civic centre in the centre of the city, are built of Portland stone, which was imported from Dorset. A widely used building stone in Cardiff is the yellow-grey Liassic limestone rock of the Vale of Glamorgan, including the very rare Sutton Stone, a conglomerate of Lias limestone and Carboniferous limestone. Limestone. Cardiff is bordered to the west by the rural district of the Vale of Glamorgan, also known as the Garden of Cardiff, to the east by the city of Newport, to the north by the South Wales Valleys and to the south by the Severn Estuary and Bristol Channel. The River Taff winds through the centre of the city and together with the River Ely flows into the freshwater lake of Cardiff Bay. A third river, the Rhymney, flows through the east of the city entering directly into the Severn Estuary. Cardiff is situated near the Glamorgan Heritage Coast, stretching westward from Penarth and Barry. Commuter towns of Cardiff, with striped yellow-blue Jurassic limestone cliffs. The Glamorgan coast is the only part of the Celtic Sea that has exposed Jurassic blue Lias geology. This stretch of coast, which has reefs, sandbanks and serrated cliffs, was a ship graveyard. Ships sailing up to Cardiff during the industrial era often never made it as far as Cardiff is. Many were wrecked around this hostile coastline during west-southwesterly gales. Consequently, smuggling, deliberate shipwrecking and attacks on ships were common destinations from Cardiff. Llantrisant, Rhondda Ponte Pryd, Brecon, Merthyr Tydfil, Caerphilly Newport, Chepstow Maesteg, Neath, Bridgend Bristol Channel. Road known as the Southern Arc are, with the exception of Cardiff Bay, some of the poorest districts of Wales with low levels of economic activity. On the other hand, Gibalfa, Plasnewydd and Cathays north of the Arc have very large student populations, and Pontcanna, situated north of Riverside and alongside Canton, is a favourite for students and young professionals. Penylan, which lies to the north-east side of Roath Park, is an affluent area popular with those with older children and the retired HMRC offices. Tye Glas in Llanishan to the west lie Ely, Carrow and Fairwater, which contain some of the largest housing estates in the United Kingdom, with the exception of some of the outlying privately built estates at Michelstone Super Ely and 1930s developments near Juan Gran Road. This is an economically disadvantaged area with high numbers of unemployed households. Culverhouse Cross is a more affluent western area of the city. Heath, Birchgrove, Gibalfa, Minichty, Llandaff North, Llandaff, Llanishan, Radyr, Whitchurch. Whilst Old Street Mellons has a history going back to the Norman Conquest in the 11th century, to the northwest of the city lies a region that may be called rural Cardiff, containing the villages of St Fagans, Creigiau, Pentyrch, Tongwynlay and Gwaelod y Garth. St Fagans, home to the Museum of Welsh Life, is protected from further development since 2000. There has been a significant change of scale and building height in Cardiff, with the development of the city centre's first purpose-built high-rise apartments. Tall buildings have been built in the city centre and Cardiff Bay, and more are planned. Climate. See also, Climate of the United Kingdom, section. ASOND. 2. Max and min temperatures in degree C. Precipitation totals in M. Source, Met Office, 1981-2010 averages. Imperial conversion. JFMAMJJASOND. 5239.26.55. Usually stays above freezing. Spring and autumn feel quite similar and the temperatures tend to stay above 14. Cardiff experiences less rainfall than the average for Wales. Rain falls in Cardiff on 146. October, November, December year record high. Degree C. Degree F. 138568 150 591 240 752 266 799 321 898 320 896. Undecillion 335. Decillion 923. Nonillion 270. Octillion 806. Septillion 246. Sextillion 763. Quintillion 171. Quadrillion 628. Trillion 167. Billion 621,335,923. Average high. Degree C. Degree F. 83469 86 475. 111-52-138-568-171-628-198-676-217-711-215-707-188-658-149-588-113-523. 87,477,147,585 daily mean degree C degree F 53415 54 417 76 457 95 491 127 549 154 597 174